أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أهل الكتاب قد جاءكم رسولنا يبين لكم على فترة من الرسل أن تقولوا ما جاءنا من بشير ولا نذير فقد جاءكم بشير ونذير والله على كل شيء قدير. O people of the book, O Jews and Christians, our messenger has come to you على فترة من الرسل, after a pause, after an interval in the messengerhood. For 600 long years, there was no messenger of Allah, no prophet present on earth. It is fatrah, awwalul fatrah, and after Muhammad, total fatrah. This institution of prophethood coming to an end in the person of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this was a preamble, a preface to the finishing of and completion of the institution of Nabuwah. Ya al kitab qad ja'akum rasuluna yubayyinu lakum ala fatratin min ar-rusul. He is making clear to you things after a gap, after an interval of the messengers. An taqulu ma ja'ana min bashirin. Lest you should say, to us there came no Bashir, no bearer of glad tidings, wala nazir, and no warner. Faqad jaakum bashirum wa nazir. Now, a bearer of the glad tidings and a warner has come to you. Wallahu ala kulli shayin qadir. And Allah is powerful, all powerful. He has power to do anything. Qala Musa li qawmihi. Now there is a very important incident of the history of Bani Israel. You know, after the Exodus, Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam took all the 12 tribes. And they say, it is written in the book of Exodus, in Bible, in the Old Testament, that they were 600,000 in number. Now they traveled in the Sinai Peninsula towards the southern tip. And there Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them Torah, called Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to Tur and gave him the Torah. Now from there they now went upwards to the north, southward, eastward and upward. And when they reached the border of Palestine, Sinai Peninsula bordering Palestine, now they were commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter Palestine and fight the people who were occupying that land. When this commandment for fighting in the way of Allah came, they all refused. We can't go to fight. This is a very important incident of their history. And due to that, they were punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they will have to roam in this desert, Sinai desert, for 40 long years. After the completion of those 40 years, when the whole of the generation which was born and raised in slavery in Egypt, they had all been finished. Along with Hazrat Musa and Hazrat Harun, all died. A new generation which was born in the desert, which was used to the hardships, they were tough in their characters. Then they made jihad and qital under the leadership of the first caliph of Hazrat Moses and his Joshua, Yosha ibn Nun, alayhi salam. So that is the incident. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. What I feel is that these ayat must have been revealed before the battle of Badr. Because there was a mention by one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about this saying, this incident, in the consultation which the Prophet had before the Battle of Badr. Hazrat Miqdad ibn al-Aswad radiyallahu ta'ala anhu referred to this incident that, oh, Messenger of Allah, we are not like the companions of Moses who said, فَذَبَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَا إِنَّا هَاوْنَا قَاعِدُونَ. We are the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You just decide whatever you like, and maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you pleased with us. Our attitude would not be that of the Jews who were accompanying Hazrat Musa. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ لِقَوْمِهِ. And just remember and recall when Musa, when Moses said to his nation, يَا قَوْمِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. O my nation, remember the blessings of Allah upon you. Is ja'ala abdikum anbiya. When he raised from amongst you prophets. Before Hazrat Musa, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam was also a prophet. He was also from Bani Israel. He was the son of Jacob. وَجَعَلَكُمْ مُلُوكًا. And he made you kings. وَآتَاكُمْ مَا لَمْ يُؤْتِ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. And he has given you what he has not given to any other nation of the world. Now this can be a prophecy also, that potentially Allah has given you. There will be big kings from amongst you. David is to come and Solomon is to come. Alayhi salatu wasalam. It can be a prophecy. And maybe he is referring to the days when, you know, Hazrat Yaqub with his whole tribe, he entered Egypt in the time when, you know, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam was occupying a very high position over there. They were very much honored by the kings at that time. The kings at that time were not Hyksos, were not the pharaohs. They were the Hyksos kings. They were also alien from the Arabian desert who had come over there and captured Egypt in that era. So they honored and respected these people who were coming from the same source. And they gave them big land holdings. So a big feudal lord is also a sort of a king, small king. So maybe he is referring to that condition, and maybe he is saying it as a prophecy that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you already, potentially, that there will be so many prophets among you and there will be big kings among you. And Allah has given you what he has not given to anybody else. And that is certainly, and that is Torah. This book in Sharia was not given to any other nation before Hazrat Moses alayhi salatu wasalam. Ya qawm idkhulu al-ard al-muqaddasa. O my nation, now enter this holy land, Palestine, enter it. Allati katab Allahu lakum. Which Allah has already assigned to you. Allah has promised. Promised land, land of our promise. They call it even today, the promised land. And actually it was promised to them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has assigned that to you. وَلَا تَرْتَدُّوا عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِكُمْ فَتَنْقَلِبُوا خَاسِرِينَ. Don't go back on your backs, you know. Don't go. Don't return. Don't reply in the negative. We are not going to fight and enter this land. فَتَنْقَلِبُوا خَاسِرِينَ. Then you will become, you know, the losers in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ يَا مُوسَىٰ إِنَّ فِيهَا قَوْمًا جَبَّارِينَ. They said, O Moses, in this land are dwelling a nation very tyrant, very strong, big warriors. وَإِنَّا لَنْ نَدْخُلَهَا أَبَدًا حَتَّى يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا. إِنَّا لَنْ نَدْخُلَهَا حَتَّى يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا. We are not going to enter there till they go out of it. فَيَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا فَإِنَّا دَاخِلُونَ. If they go out of it, if they vacate the land for us, then we shall enter. قَالَ رَجُلَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ يَخَافُونَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمَا. Two persons who had the fear of Allah in their hearts and whom Allah had blessed. They were Joshua ibn Nun and Kalib ibn Yafanna. Two companions of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. They stood up. قَالَ رَجُلَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ يَخَافُونَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمَا. اُدْخُلُوا عَلَيْهُمُ الْبَابِ. Oh, our people, take the courage. Just you enter. Enter this land. فَإِذَا دَخَلْتُمُوهُ فَإِنَّكُمْ غَالِبُونَ. If you show this much courage, you enter the land, you will overpower them. You will be victorious. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised you this land. So actually only the testing is to show courage. That's the only thing that is required out of you. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَتَوَكَّلُوا. And you should place all your faith and all your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in kuntum mu'minin, if you are really mu'min. قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى. They said it in the most decisive tone. إِنَّا لَن نَدْخُلَهَا أَبَدًا مَا دَامُوا فِيهَا. We are never going to enter this land so long as they are there. فَذْهَبْ أَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ. So go you and your Lord. فَقَاتِلَا. And make war upon them. إِنَّا هَا هُنَا قَائِدُونَ. We are sitting here. We are not going to make a move. جَمِي جُمْبَدْ نَجُمْبَدْ قُلْ مُحَمَّدْ. We are sitting here. Now let me say something which you may call apology for the Bani Israel. Why did they say so? Is an apology from them. Why? Due to recurring miracles, they were used to it. If your asa, you know, could make a way in the ocean or in the sea, why can't you go with this asa, drive them out? That is why there was no miracle with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have to work for it. You have to suffer for it. You have to take each step yourself. You have to go hungry. You might have to go thirsty. You will be persecuted. Allah will not hold back the hands of Abu Jahl or anybody else from persecuting you. So that you are not given to miracles. Work your way. That is very important. They had the miracles after miracles. They needed water, and one striking of this staff of Moses on the rock, and 12, you know, springs gushing out. So they were used to it. They were given to it. They wanted a miracle. فَذَبَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَا إِنَّا هَوْنَا قَاعِدُونَ. But I only wanted to make it clear. That is why in the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will find no miracle of that type. The miracle is this Quran. It is the mojza of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was stoned. But no angels came and prevented. Wasn't it so? فَذَبَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَا إِنَّا هَا هُنَا قَاعِدٌ قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لَا أَمْلِكُ إِلَّا نَفْسِي وَأَخِي. Moses said, oh my Lord, I don't have any authority except on my own self and my brother Harun. فَفْرُقْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. So now please separate us from these people who are transgressors. قَالَ فَإِنَّهَا مُحَرَّمَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ. It is not written here, but it is implied that the request of Moses was not granted. You have to remain with them. And he remained with them till the last. While he was so much annoyed by the attitude of his people that he wanted to go off from them, leave them. فَفْرُقْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. No. Remain with them. But we will punish them. And what is the punishment? فَإِنَّهَا مُحَرَّمَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. Now this holy land, which we had already promised to them, it is forbidden for them for 40 long years. يَتِيهُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. They will have to wander in this land, in this Sinai Peninsula, in this desert. And as I told you, during these 40 years, the whole generation which was raised in slavery, and you know this gives a special mentality to the people. We can experience it of ourselves. We remained under the Britishers for 200 years or 100 years. So our mentalities were changed. Courage gone. We became defeatist in our mentality. Apologetic in our attitudes. Same was the condition of the Bani Israel. Due to a long period of slavery, their courage was crushed. So that was now the new generation sprang. Fitrat ke maqasid ki karta hai nigehbani, ya bandai sehrai ya marde kohistani. In the Sahara, the desert, a new generation sprung, and that generation made the jihad fi sabilillah. Watlu alayhim naba ibn adama bilhaq. Now, because you know, killing, slaughtering people, murdering people, as we had noted, one of the biggest crimes. The basis of human society is respect for human life. Except when, you know, somebody has killed anybody else, then he will be killed in, you know, qisas. Or there are three other forms also. But by and large, the human life is very sacred. Now, for this, you know, for the sanctity of human life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is narrating the incident which happened very early in human history. Two sons of Adam. وَطْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَبْنَي آدَمَ بِالْحَقِّ. Narrate to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the story of two sons of Adam, Habil and Qabil, Abel and Cain. اِسْقَرَّبَا قُرْبَانًا. Both of them offered a sacrifice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا. From one it was accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنَ الْآخَرِ, and it was not accepted from the other. Now what was the sign that it has been accepted? In those earlier days, those were the days of miracles. A fire descended from heaven and burnt the thing that was presented as a sacrifice for Allah, if it was accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُرْبَانٍ يَاكُلُهُمْ نَارِ. That is why it was demanded from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also, as a proof of his truthfulness. If he is a messenger of Allah, you should also show this miracle. That was, you know, the custom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the beginning. When, you know, humanity was in its childhood. So they needed something which can be seen, and you know, some miracles and some absolutely out of the way things to believe something. Now humanity is mature enough to use the intellect. And the biggest guide and light for that intellect we have given you, and this is the miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it was accepted by, from one and not accepted from the other. Qala, then he said, it is Qabil, whose sacrifice was not accepted. He became jealous. And he said, Laqtulannak, I will kill you. Qala, innama yataqabbalu Allahu min al-muttaqeen. Habil said, oh, Allah accepts it from only the God-fearing people, people who have taqwa, who love Allah. You should look, peep down to your heart, why Allah has rejected your sacrifice. You should try to mend your ways. Why be angry with me? لَإِن بَسَطْتَ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لَتَقْتُلَنِي. If you outstretch your hand, your arm to kill me, مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطِ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لَيَقْتُلُكَ. I'm not going to extend my hand to kill you. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can't kill you. Killing a man is forbidden, haram. إِنِّي أُرِيدُ أَن تَبُوَ بِإِسْمِي. I want that if you are not, you know, going back on what you are saying, if you will kill me, what will it result? You will have my sins also upon you. So I want to punish you. I want to give you the biggest punishment. And what is that? إِنِّي أُرِيدُ أَن تَبُوَ بِإِسْمِي وَإِسْمِكُ. If you kill me, you will take upon yourself my sins also, in addition to your own sins. Whosoever is killed, you know, if he was innocent, all his sins are burdened over the killer. So he loses nothing. He had to die anyhow. Not if today, tomorrow. Not tomorrow, day after. Death is to come. But if somebody takes upon himself all your sins, you are not the loser. إِنِّي أُرِيدُ أَن تَبُوَ بِإِسْمِي وَإِسْمِكُ فَتَكُونَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. And then you will become among the people of the fire. وَذَلِكَ جَزَاءُ الظَّالِمِينَ. And this is the reward and recompense for the evildoers and for the transgressors. فَتَوَّعَتْ لَهُ نَفْسُهُ قَتْلَ أَخِيهِ. His baser self, his animal self prompted him to kill his brother. Now there's always, you know, a conflict within you. Should I do it? No, don't do it. It is haram. Something within you says, don't do it. But something again within you says, oh, go ahead. Why don't you kill him? This conflict between evil and good goes on in between and within the inner personality of your own. So that is to which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring. His baser self, his nafs-e ammara, inna nafs al-ammara bisu, it prompted him to take that courage and kill the brother. فَتَوَّعَتْ لَهُ نَفْسَهُ قَتْلَ أَخِيهِ فَقَتَلَهُ And he killed him. فَأَصْبَحَ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ And then he became repenting. He became, you know, became losers. And he said, فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ غَرَابًا يَبْحَثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ Allah sent, you know, a crow who was scratching the earth. Maybe there is some, you know, in background, maybe some crow had died, and then the crow comes and scratches the earth so that there is a pit to bury the body of that crow. Maybe all this thing was shown to Qabil by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through crow. فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ غُرَابًا يَبْحَثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُرِيَهُ كَيْفَ يُوَارِي سَوَاءَ أَخِيهِ To show him how to hide the dead corpse, the dead body of his brother. Because it was very early days of human history and culture. Now we didn't know what to do with him. I've killed my brother. What to do with the dead body? Let it rot here, in the open, in the sun. What to do? But Allah sent a crow. He scratched the earth. And he had the guidance from that, that I can, you know, bury my the dead body of my brother. قَالَ يَا وَيْلَتَا عَجَزْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِثْلَ هَذَا الْغُرَابِ And then he said, woe to me. I was not able to be equal to this crow even. فَوَارِيَ سَوَتَ أَخِي So that I could myself think how to cover the body, dead body of my brother. فَأَصْبَحَ مِنَ النَّادِمِينَ And now he became regretful, remorseful. مِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ كَتَبْنَا عَلَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ For that reason we had declared upon Bani Israel, what he declared, أَنَّهُ مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ If a person kills another person, except in revenge for a murder, if somebody has killed somebody, well, he can be killed in revenge as a punishment. But if he has not done that, not committed that crime, or fasad in fil ard, or if somebody is doing mischief in the land, he has raised a rebellion, now he is committing, you know, dacoities, mischief. For these crimes, somebody can be hanged, somebody can be killed. But if without these two reasons, بغير نفسنا فساد في الأرض, if somebody kills another human being, فكانما قتل الناس جميعا, it is as if he has killed the whole of humanity. Because he is cutting at the roots of human society. That is the very basic foundation of the human society. Respect for each other's life. How can you live together if you don't respect each other's life? How can you live together if you don't respect each other's right of property? These two things are basic for human culture and society, social order. So you are cutting the root. So as if you have murdered the whole of humanity. وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا And whosoever saves one human life, فَكَانَّمَا أَحْيَى النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا It is like saving the whole of humanity. وَلَقَدْ جَاتْهُمْ رُسُلُنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ And our messengers came to them with clear teachings. بَيِّنَات بَيِّن is something which is self-evident. This word is used for miracles also. This word is used for ayatul Quran also. Ayatul Bayyinat. And the teachings of the deen of Allah, which are very open and which are very clear to the soul of human beings. وَلَقَدْ جَاهُمْ رُسُلُّنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ ثُمَّ إِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِّنْهُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فِي الْأَرْضِ لَمُسْرِفُونَ But even after them, many of them in the land, they are treacherous. They exceed the limits of the Sharia. Innama jazaa'ul ladheena, now this is the rule for the Muslims now. That was a story which was related of Abel and Cain, Habil and Qabil. Now with this background, what is the commandment now? Innama jazaa'ul ladheena yuharibuna Allah wa rasulahu. Verily the recompense of those who go to war against Allah and His Messenger. And you know, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Islamic State takes the place of Allah and His Rasul. Whosoever is rebellious against Islamic State, in the times of Rasul, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, going war against the Messenger of Allah. Inna ladina yuharibuna Allah wa rasulahu. But now, after his death, it's the Islamic State. If a real Islamic State is present, established, whosoever stands as a rebel against it, who wages war against it, innama jazaa'ul ladheena yuharibuna Allah wa rasulahu wa yas'una fil ardi fasadan, and they want to make mischief in the land, the recompense is only an yuqattalu, they should be murdered, killed. And taqtil means they should be butchered. Taqtil. Not only qatl, yuqtalu nahi. Yuqtalu. They should be butchered. Or yusallabu. Or they should be crucified. Or tuqatta aydihim wa arjuluhum min khilafin. Or their hands or feet should be cut from opposite sides. Or yunfa min al-ard. Or they should be exiled from the land. Turned out from that land. Zalika lahum khizyun fid dunya. And this is going to be for them a dishonor in this world and degradation in this world. وَلَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. And in the hereafter there will be for them a very big punishment. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن تَقْدِرُوا عَلَيْهِمْ. Except those who repent and mend their ways before you overpower them. Now just look to it. There's an Islamic State. Some people have stood up in rebellion, challenging the state, waging war against the state. Now, before the state is able to overpower them, if they repent, if they make tawbah, and if they amend their ways, then they will not be killed. But if the state has overpowered them, and then they say, we make tawbah and we apologize, no. The time of tawbah, gone. That is the thing given. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَعْبُوا مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن تَقْدِرُوا عَلَيْهِمْ. Except those who repent and mend their ways before you overpower them. فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So you should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also forgiving. Then forgive them. Because they have on their own repented and mended their ways. Allah is merciful. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةَ. وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you who believe, have taqwa of Allah. وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةِ. And seek the ways and means of becoming nearer and nearer to Him. If you are really mu'min, if you love Allah, you must gradually. This is called suluk, to go. Sair ilallah, you are approaching Allah. Not with your feet, with your heart. With your heart and mind. You are becoming nearer and nearer and nearer to Allah. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, taqullah wa abtaghu ilayhi wasila. Means of becoming nearer and nearer to Allah. And what are these means? This vow now, it is the vow of tafsir, vow of explanation. وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And strive hard in His way. The striving hard in the way of Allah is the wasila. The harder you strive in the path of Allah, the nearer you come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةَ وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So that you may be successful and prosperous. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ أَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Verily those who disbelieve and reject the faith, لَوْ أَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا, had with them be had they got with them all the wealth of the whole of the world, وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ, and more with it, twofold of the whole of the wealth of the earth, لَيَفْتَدُوا بِهِ, to ransom themselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, from the punishment on the day of judgment. مَا تُقُبِّلَ مِنْهُمْ, it will not be accepted from them. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ, and for them is a very big and painful torment. يُرِيدُونَ أَن يَخْرُجُوا مِنَ النَّارِ, they will keep on trying to get out of the fire. وَمَا هُمْ بِخَارِجِينَ مِنْهَا, and they will not be able to get out of it. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُقِيمٌ, and for them will be the punishment which is lasting, persisting, permanent. مُقِيم. وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقَةُ, now the second thing, as I told you, respect for human life. The other thing is respect for property. You shouldn't steal. You can have a bargain, you can have trading, you earn from each other. You can work for somebody and you can get the wages from him, everything, okay. But to steal, that is wrong. وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقَةُ, and a thief, whether he is a male or a female, فَقْطَعُوا أَيْدِيَهُمَا, chop off the hands of both. This is the punishment. جَزَامْ بِمَا كَسَبَا, it's the recompense for what they have earned. نَكَالَمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ, it's an exemplary punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah wants to eradicate theft from the society. And definitely, these, you know, punishments of Islam, they are exemplary. They are very stern, no doubt. But we accept, yes, they are correct. Without that, you know, this theft and murdering, it cannot be rooted out from the society. What is happening to the West? Despite all the education, all the means of persuasion, all these communication, media, everything is there. Still, most heinous crime, it is prospering here. Why? Because the punishments are not strong. You can have the example of some of the Muslim countries. For example, used to be the case in Saudi Arabia, no theft whatsoever. But now because they themselves have become loosened, you know, it's a different case now. But a few years earlier, about 10, 15 years earlier, no theft, no trace of any theft. Only during the days of Hajj, because, you know, people came from other countries, especially Yemenis, they committed theft. But no Saudi individual never committed any theft. Al-Imanu Yamaniyun. This is that saying of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But I don't want to tell you the incident, you know. But I think you should go further. وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقُ فَقْطَعُوا أَيْدِيَهُمَا جَزَاءً بِمَا كَسَبَا نَكَالًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ فَمَنْ تَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ظُلْمِهِ, whosoever repents and mends his way after committing this sin, وَأَصْلَحَ, he has corrected himself, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتُوبُ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, so Allah will also turn towards him with compassion, with mercy, with forgiveness. And he is the forgiving one, and he is the merciful one. So now, this is not, you know, if you have committed the theft, you have incurred upon you two things. A punishment here, and a punishment in the hereafter. Tawbah will save you from the punishment of the hereafter, not of this world. If a thief says, well, I make Tawbah. Okay. You must make tawbah so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, he saves you from the punishment of the hereafter. But here, this had of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is hududullah, it must be executed. The punishment will be given here. Alam ta'alam anna Allah lahu mulku samawati wal ard. Don't you know that to Allah belongs the sovereignty and kingdom of all the heavens and the earth. يُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. He will punish whomsoever He pleases and He will forgive whomsoever He pleases. وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And Allah has authority over everything. يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ لَا يَحْزُنْكَ الَّذِينَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْكُفْرِ. Now this word, يُسَارِعُونَ, سَارِعُوا, it will come many a times now. So you understand the what is the essence. سُرْعَة, speediness. If one is, you know, working hard for some end, this is يُسَارِعُوا, فِي, for that cause, for that end, for that purpose, for that goal. Then مُسَارَعَة, competition. We compete with each other. I want to go ahead. I want to do more service to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to do more service to Deen. So this is musara'ah. You are competing with each other as if in a race. So, alam, ya ayyuha rasulullah yahzunka. O Messenger of Allah, let not those people grieve you who are striving and moving in all the directions. Fil kufr. Fi sabilil kufr. They are striving for disbelief against Allah, against the Islamic State, against you, against the Muslim society. مِنَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِأَفْوَاهِمْ. And they are two groups. Number one is, from among those who say with their lips and mouths, we believe. وَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. And their hearts do not believe. What does it mean? مُنَافِقُونَ. There were two groups there, you know, who were active against the Islamic State, against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا. And the second group, from among the Jews. Now there was, you know, so to say, a joint front among them, between them, against this Islamic State, against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't be grieved. Allah will tackle them. They will not be able to do any harm to you. And what are the attributes of these people? سَمَّعُونَ لِلْكَذِبِ. They listen very much to whatever is false. Their hearts jump and are attracted towards lies and falsehood. سَمَّعُونَ لِقَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ. And they listen for on behalf of another people. Munafiqeen came to the sittings where the Prophet ﷺ was sitting, you know, meetings of the Prophet, and they were, you know, as fifth columnist, they were hearing what is happening here, what decisions are being taken. And then they went to the Jews, tell them, now today this has been decided. This is going to be done. So they are listening for others. سَمَّعُونَ لِقَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ. For other people, لَمْ يَعْتُوكَ, who don't come to you. They are not coming to you, but they are their agents. They are here to listen for them. يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوَاضِعِهِ. And they change the context of the words after that being fixed. يَقُولُونَ إِنْ أُوتِيتُمْ هَذَا فَخُزُوهُ. And they say to each other, if you are given this thing, accept it. They used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taking a dispute, decide this. But they had already decided beforehand that if the Prophet decides this way, accept his judgment. But if he decides the other way, reject it. So that was a conspiracy. Apparently they are coming to the Prophet, oh Prophet, oh Messenger of Allah, we have a dispute, please judge between us. Very innocently. But actually it was a conspiracy. They have pre-decided it. If the decision is this, accept it. If not, you save yourself. يَقُولُونَ إِنْ أُوْتِيْتُمْ هَذَا فَخُذُوهُ وَإِنْ لَمْ تُؤْتَوْهُ فَعْذَرُوا. If you are not given that verdict, then you keep away. وَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ فِتْنَتَهُ. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting in fitna, in temptation, in trial, فَلَنْ تَمْلِكُ لَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْعَى. You will not have any authority in favor of him to save him from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أولئك الذين لم يرد الله أن يطهر قلوبهم. They are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not wished to purify their souls and hearts. لهم في الدنيا خزي. For them is disgrace in this world. ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم. And in the hereafter for them there will be a very big punishment. سمعون للكذب. They listen to whatever is false. Very much like the lies. أكالون للسحت. They eat the unlawful. Haram. فَإِنْ جَاؤُوكَ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ أَوْ أَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ. If they come to you, O Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's up to you. If you decide to judge between them, okay. And if you decide not to judge between them, because you can see through their intentions. If they are sincere, if they want actually to take your judgment, well, go ahead. Give the judgment, give the verdict. You have to spend some time to listen to both the parties. Your time is very precious. But if you feel that it is only a conspiracy, they don't really or sincerely want a verdict from me, then aris anhum. Then you just turn away from them. Okay, no, I'm not going to take your case. Take it to somebody else. Go to your own rabbis. Go to your own chieftains. Aris anhum, find toris anhum. And if you turn away from them, فَلَنْ يَضُرُّكَ شَيْئًا, there could be a fear that they will go, you know, and make it a scandal. Well, look to this person. He says he claims to be a messenger of Allah. And we went to him with a dispute. Please give us a verdict. And he is refusing. What type of a messenger of Allah he is? They could scandalize it. But Allah says, don't worry, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't worry. لَنْ يَضُرُّكَ, they will not be able to harm you, شَيْئًا, even a little. وَإِنْ حَكَمْتَ فَحَكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطِ. But if you decide to judge, then you judge between them with qist, equity, justice. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the equitables only, who do justice. وَكَيْفَ يُحَكِّمُونَكَ. And how are they making you a judge? وَعِنْدَهُمُ التَّوْرَاهُ. Although they have the Torah with them, the book of Allah is there, the Sharia is there. فِيهَا حُكْمُ اللَّهِ. In that Torah, the judgment of Allah is already with them. ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّوْنَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. But after that, they are turning away from Torah. Actually, what happened, you know, there was a case of fornication between a Jew man and a Jew woman, and both were married. They knew it, that the punishment according to Torah is stoning to death, rajum. Well, they said, go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maybe because they might have known that there is no ayatul rajm in Quran. So maybe we will be saved from there. And we shall say, well, we had the verdict from the court of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they came there. And they belonged to Khaybar. Came from Khaybar all the way. The Prophet said, what is the punishment in Torah? They said, no, no, we don't know. There's nothing. قُلْ فَاتُوا بِالتَّوْرَاتِ فَتْلُوهَ. The Prophet said, bring the book. And someone of them was, he put a hand on that ayah to hide it. Then you know, he was asked to remove his hand and the ayah was there. And the Prophet decided, I declare, on the authority of Torah, both of them, because they are married, must be stoned to death. So this is it. ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّوْنَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. They are actually turning their backs to the law of Torah. وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. They are not the believers. They neither believe in you, nor they believe in Torah. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاكَ. Now this section is very important. حُكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ. To a community, to a nation, to an ummah, to whom Sharia has been given, if this community is not judging matters according to their Sharia, they are the kafirs, they are the fasits, they are the zalims, they are the mushriks. A very stern verdict for all of the Muslims of today. You think you are Muslims? You think you are Mormons? And your lands are the courts enforcing the law of Sharia? Are the punishments of Quran and Sunnah being given? So who you are then? It's a very stern verdict. Prepare yourself for the shock. Inna anzalna Tawrat. We sent down Torah. Fiha hudam wa noor. In that book also, there was guidance and light. Yahkumu bihan nabiyyun. With according to the law of Torah, the prophets used to judge. Min al-lazin. Nabiyyun al-lazin aslamu. Because they were themselves Muslims. Every prophet was Muslim. Who was Ibrahim? Muslim. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لِلَّذِينَ هَادُوا. They used to judge and decide the matters of the Jews. وَالرَّبَّانِيُّونَ وَالْأَحْبَارِ. Not only the prophets, but also Rabbani means people, men who love Allah, Rabb. Allah wale, whom we call in Urdu. People who are in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ahbar, and they are, you know, jurists, fuqaha, they were giving the verdicts according to the Torah. They must tuhfizu min kitabillah, because they were entrusted the protection of the book of Allah. Wa kanu alayhi shuhada, and they were the witnesses to that. Fala takhshabun nasa bakhshawni. So you, O Jews, don't fear men, fear me. وَلَا تَشْتَرُوا بِآيَاتِ سَمِيًا قَلِيلًا. And don't sell my ayat, my laws, my decrees, my sharia, against a very small, trivial price. What will you get here? If you are selling a fatwa, a wrong fatwa, you might have had maybe $1 million, for example. What are those $1 million? Maybe you die tomorrow, and the dollars will go to somebody else. A trivial price, but we have sold a wrong fatwa. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And whosoever doesn't judge and decide according to what Allah has sent down, verily they are the kafirs. They are the rejecters of the faith. They might claim to be Muslims and Mu'mins, and they might claim to be very high, having a very high position spiritually. But in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the kafirs. مَنْ لَمْ يَعْكُمْ بِمَانُ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَهُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا. And we had decided for them, prescribed for them in fiha, in that Torah, أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ. Life will be taken for life. Somebody kills, he will be killed. وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ. Eye for eye. وَالْأَنْفَ بِالْأَنْفِ. Nose for nose. وَالْأُذْنَ بِالْأُذْنِ. Ear for ear. If somebody has cut the ear of another person, his ear will also be cut, chopped off. وَالْسِنَّ بِالسِنِّ. And a tooth for a tooth. وَالْجُرُوحَ قِصَاصِ. And in the same way, there will be equality in all the injuries. فَمَنْ تَصَدَّقَ بِهِ فَهُوَ كَفَّارَةٌ لَهُ. Whosoever foregoes it in charity, okay, you did it to me, I am not going to do it to you. I forgive you. This will become a kaffara, an expiation of his sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive some of his sins because he has forgiven his brother who did something wrong with him, but he didn't take the revenge. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And whosoever doesn't judge by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down, they are the zalims. They are the evildoers. And the another meaning of this word zalim is they are the mushriks. Inna shirka la zulmun azeem. Shirk, associating someone with Allah, is the biggest zulm. You are zalimun. Actually, this is shirk. You have a law, divine law. You have a human law. You are deciding by human law, not divine law. You are making this human being or the framers of this law equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rather greater than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have rejected the law of Allah and accepted the law of a human being or a nation. What is parliament, a representative of human beings? It is making a law. Homosexuality, permissible. Two males married, okay. Two females married, okay. They are making it. But who are they? They are human beings. They have framed this law. If you accept this law, instead of the law of Allah, you have made them higher than Allah. It's more than shirk. فَبَلَّمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ وَقَفَّيْنَا عَلَىٰ أَثَارِهِمْ بِعِيسَى ابْنِ مَرْيَمَ. And in their footsteps, so many Anbiya came between Moses and Hazrat Masih. Ala asarihim, in their footsteps, we sent Isa ibn Maryam, alayhi salatu wassalam, musaddiqan lima bayna yadayhi min at-Torah, confirming that which was present before him min at-Torah, from Torah. Wa atainahu al-Injil, and in addition we gave him Injil. Fihi hudam wa noor. Just like Torah, in Injil also, there was guidance as well as noor, as well as light. But musaddiqan lima bayna yadayhi min at-Torah. Again the words are repeated. Confirming what was present before him from Torah. Why this repetition? I thought over it today, and my mind says that first recognition is that Torah was the book of Allah. This is first confirmation. And the second confirmation is denoting to the saying of the Prophet Jesus, alayhi salatu wassalam, don't think I have come to destroy law. This is tasdeeq. The law of Moses will be applicable to you also. These words are there in the gospel up till now. Go and read the gospel according to Saint Matthew. You find the words. Don't think I have come to destroy law. Saint Paul abrogated law. So actually modern, present Christianity is not Christianity. It is Paulism. He abrogated law. The law of Moses. While Jesus says, and his saying is preserved in the Gospels, even today, don't think I have come to destroy law. Confirming the law and confirming the book, both. The Torah was Allah's book, one confirmation. And its law is applicable to you also, that is the second confirmation. وَهُدَمْ وَمَوْعِذَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It was a guidance and admonishment and advice for those who have taqwa. وَلْيَحْكُمْ أَهْلُ الْإِنْجِيلِ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ. People who believe in Injil, they should judge according to Injil. If Injil says the law of Moses is applicable to you, how can you abrogate? Who is Paul to abrogate? وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. Third verdict. And whosoever doesn't judge and decide things according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down, they are the fasiqs, they are the rebellious ones. They are challenging the law of Allah, the authority of Allah. Who is a rebel? A rebel is a person who doesn't accept and challenges the government. وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. How beautiful. We gave Torah to Moses, we gave Injil to Jesus. Now, إِنَّا وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ. And now we have sent this book, Al-Quran, with the total truth. Bil-haq, I told you. Not the truth only, the total truth. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ. And it is also confirming that Injil was Allah's book, Torah was Allah's book. وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. And it is guardian over that, because the texts of these two books have been corrupted. So it is guarding, guardian, muhaiminan, muhaiminan alayh. Fahkum bainahum bima anzalallah. So O Muhammad, you now judge according to what Allah has sent down upon you. Wala tattabi ahwahum. Don't follow their lusts and wishes. Amma jaaka min al-haq. And you go away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to you from the total truth. Trying to please them, following their wishes. لِكُلِّنْ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرَةً وَمِنْ هَاجَا. For each one of you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared One Shira, one Sharia, the ritual and the law. To Moses, we gave a law. Now, basically that law is the same, but there are amendments. The law of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is different from the law of Moses in many respects. So Allah gave them to, they gave that Sharia to Bani Israel and this Sharia to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَجْعَلَكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. Had Allah wished so, He would have made you all one ummah. He could have sent Quran from the very beginning. He could do it. But it is His hikmah. Because humanity was coming up of age, intellectually progressing, evolving. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according with the intellectual evolution and social evolution of humanity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was giving, you know, the instructions. So Torah had the interim instructions. Total truth has been revealed now in this book. وَلَكِنْ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِي مَا آتَاكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you in what He has given to you, whether you cling to the form or the essence. Form of deen has changed. Essence of deen is the same. The deen of Moses, deen of Isa, deen of Muhammad is the same. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى. The deen has been one, but the shara'i are different. Shira'atan wa minhaj are different. Methodology is different. Methodology of Ibrahim was different. Methodology of Yusuf was different. Methodology of Moses was different. Methodology of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is different. But now we have to follow the methodology of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been making these changes to test you, whether you cling to the form only or you can see to the essence of the thing. And whether you are racist or nationalist or seeker of the truth, because this is my nation, this is the book we believe in, I will cling to it, or you are the seeker after truth. If you are a seeker for the truth, then the al-haq, the total truth is, has now come in the form of Quran. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. So, O Muslims, or humanity at large, you should compete with each other, as in a race, for all the virtuous and righteous things. إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ. To Allah is going to be your return, jami'a, all of you. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ فِيهِ تَخْتَلِفُونَ. And then Allah will tell you, make it clear for you, in whatever you were differing. All the differences will be settled on that day. وَأَنِحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا عَنُّ اللَّهِ. And judge, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between them, according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعَ هُوَاهُمْ. And don't follow their lusts and wishes. وَعَذَرْهُمْ أَنْ يَفْتِنُوكَ عَمْ بَعْدِ مَا عَنْزُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. And beware of them, lest they should take you away from the path, from that thing, their sharia, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down on you. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا. And if they are turning their backs, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُصِيبَهُمْ بِبَعْضِ ذُنُوبِهِمْ. Then you should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to inflict them with some punishment due to their sins. وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ لَفَاسِقُونَ. And verily, the majority and many of the people, they are the transgressors. The last ayah in this passage is very grand. أَفَحُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَبْغُونَ. Do they want to have the judgments of the days of ignorance? Days of ignorance before Wahi came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is Jahiliyyah. What do they want? They don't want, they don't like the judgment of Allah. As I told you, you know, many Muslims in the British courts during the British Raj in India, they used to stand up in the courts and say, we don't want any verdict according to the law of inheritance of Islam. Muslim declaring it. أَفَحُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَبْغُونَ. Do they want the judgment of Jahiliyyah? وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمًا لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ. Who can be better than Allah in the judgments and in the decisions and in the law? For those people who have faith in Him, they know that the best law, the best Sharia is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.